Hi guys, and welcome to a super quick template on a personal budget. Now, we've all been there, taking in your monthly salary and really calculating what your personal budget is for the month. Now, we want to take it to the next level and extrapolate that, taking into consideration some investment income, some additional income or expenses you may have, and really extrapolate your accumulated savings each month and visually display them in a nice chart. So I'm going to walk you through the couple of steps that you need to take in order to arrive at such a nice overview. First of all, we have three sheets that we need to look at. We're starting off with our salary calculation. Now we want to enter our annual gross salary and the number of salary payments per year. This yields the gross salary each month, and we also see the annual total of it. Now, coming from gross to net is super specific to the different countries. Now, I'm giving you a sample. So let's say I'm calculating with 15% of taxes, a bit of other, health insurance, unemployment insurance, all these kinds of things. And you see that these are calculated automatically, right? As a percentage of your gross salary each month. Now, in your particular case, these may change. So feel free to change these pieces right here, adjust the percentages, adjust the categories, whatever you want to do. Sometimes it may also be a fixed payment, then you should enter it right here in the gray cell. Now, at the end, you will arrive at your monthly net salary. This number, we're just going to take it and take it over to the personal budget right here. So we have our net salary each month. I'm just going to quickly zoom in. Now, we started with our monthly fixed costs. How much do we spend each month on rent, car insurance, gasoline, online services, our cell phone, Wi-Fi, and so on and so forth, right? You have plenty of space to be super creative and enter your own categories, and then also enter the amounts, of course. And then we can see what our subtotal in terms of fixed cost is each month. And we can also see the percentage of this. So you see that by far, rent is the biggest impact we have in terms of a fixed cost each month. But then, of course, we also have variable costs. So we need to take them into consideration as well. What are variable costs? Well, variable costs basically means you need to decide how much you want to spend on it. And super free, right? So sometimes you're spending $300 on groceries. Sometimes it's just $200. Sometimes you're eating out a bit more, sometimes a bit less. Shopping is also very, very variable. And there are all different kinds of categories that you can put in to again calculate your subtotal for variable costs. In the end is just a mathematical calculation. You're taking your net salary each month, you deduct your monthly fixed costs and your variable costs, and you're left with a net disposable income. So this money can go directly into your savings, or it can go directly into an investment, whatever you want to do. So this number, we're going to keep that in mind and go over to the monthly savings evolution. What do we have here? Now, we essentially have our monthly net salary coming from the salary calculation. If you have any kind of government bonds, or if you're holding any stocks and you're subject to dividend payouts, you can enter passive income that you may have each month. So let's say that in September, you get $1,000 in dividends. You can enter this one in. Let's say you're selling your car in November for $9,000, and you can enter this one in. At the same time, you know, you've sold your car and you want to upgrade a bit more, so you're paying $15,000 on a new car. So this is how you calculate your total monthly income, your expenses, and you arrive at the cumulative savings per month. The cumulative savings per month mean this is the total savings of each month added up. In addition to that, you may have another bank account somewhere with a cash balance on it. You may have a stock portfolio whose value changes. You may also be holding some other assets. And each and every month, what you can do is go ahead and enter the total value of your stock portfolio or the total value of your bank accounts. And this will then give you your total assets. In other words, this is going to be your net worth, assuming that you have no liabilities to pay back. So in the end, This is going to give you the monthly savings evolution. That just means that each and every month, so the gray bars right here, that's going to depict your cash flow coming in each month. And the green line is going to show you the total net assets that you have at the end of the month. So looking from June to June, so a 3-year horizon, looks quite nice, huh? From 13 grand to 114. Now this is of course provided that, you know, all of the assumptions right here really materialize, but generally speaking, I think you get the idea. The idea really is for you to plan your monthly cash-ins, to plan your savings, maybe play around a bit with your variable costs. You may wanna move into a smaller or a bigger flat to really see the impact on your net disposable income, and then to also calculate what the net impact at the end of 3 years is gonna be. So I hope that with this template, you have a great way of really planning your savings evolutions, and I hope that you find this useful.